Hello and welcome to this review of Weinsberg 600 DQ. We've been driving around in it for 9 days now, and we've been driving from Nuremberg to Austria, Switzerland, and back up again to Nuremberg. It's a 2.3 liter. I think it's 120 horsepower. I think it's the smallest module you can get. Even in 15% climbs and so on, I haven't seen any problems. Maybe longer hills or whatever, maybe you can't drive 130, 140, but then again, do you really want to drive that fast? I've been driving 120, 130, even 140 on the highway without any problems at all. So engine wise, I don't see any problems in it. Here in the, you can see that we have an awning, which I think is really, really nice to have. It gives off shadow, especially when you're standing in here and have to cook. Maybe not so much shadow for when you're sitting outdoor, as you can see the boys there playing right now. But at least it gives you shadows for standing and cooking, and it should help with keeping it cool inside so the sun is not going directly in the van if you're in a sun place. If we try to go around here, as you can see, it has water here, which I believe is like 60 liters of water. There's a good amount of space in the garage here. It's all our dirty clothes right now, but it's not too bad. There's a small space here, and then here that's where the fresh water is. Over here you have space for two gas bottles. I have no clue how much we have been using, but we only used one, so at least for 9 days one is enough. And you can see there's space for a battery, and there's space for a little bit extra. It's like a cabinet where you have to lift up the door. I don't think it's that smart made at all. In general, it's an okay brand, but you feel like it's a little bit cheap. And when you look at the inside here, you can see that there's a mosquito net for the door. We haven't used it too much. It's so fragile. So and since it's a rental, we didn't want to use it. When we go inside here, you can see that we can actually we can turn the two chairs. Maybe we could get May to try to turn one of the chairs here, so you can see how easy it is when we're inside. Then you can just turn it around. And this is mainly where me and May, we've been sitting in the chairs, and the boys has been sitting on the other table. One thing we are missing here is that this table is really feels a little bit fragile as well, because when you look here, you can see that it's only attached over here. We missed some kind of beam or support going down there, so that it would have been a little bit more sturdy. And the captain's chairs can turn around as well. Inside here, it's a Fiat Ducato. It's really nice. You can close the curtains here. I just opened it now so we can see a little bit more light, but there's a lot of cabinets in here. We had aircon, but it's like this old aircon, you have to put it in 3-4 different ways. It has I actually don't know what you call that in Danish. English is cigar plug or whatever, and there's a USB as well. For that one, we have an anchor charger, which works really well. So buy a proper brand there if you're gonna use that. And then yeah, there's space for everything down here for drinks, but it's not so nice when you're driving to have to reach down there. So here there's place for you where you can put a drink as well. If we look over here, this is where the boys are sitting behind us. We put in the outer chairs because actually they could fit. I would say that maybe if you have some bumpers or whatever they call, just the bottom chairs, that would have been nicer. They're so big and it means that we can't sit there. They're only made for them. Up here we have a small cabinet. It's really nice with this fabric here that you can just put in things and it keeps it in place. And as you can see, there's a USB plug here as well. One thing that would have been really, really nice would be a 230 volts is just above that. I think you can buy that as extra equipment, but come on, why is only one? Why is that the only thing included? all or most of the lights are touch, so you just touch them and then they turn on and off. Really nice as well. The windows is Truma windows, like we knew it from a caravan and so on. It has a mosquito net and a blackout curtains as well. Again, it works. You can see that they're just taking standard components and putting into it. They're not developing their own. Over here, we have a two-stove burner with ignition thing, the one you push, so you don't need a lighter or anything like that. Works really well. It's on all the time. And it just works. Our pan and pots were maybe a little bit too big. The next time we should bring a smaller one. Here we have a water pot and cold. Again, it's small, but come on, it's a small van. We were able to use it. As you can see, we found out in the end that you could actually turn it. We wish that it could turn like this way. There's three drawers here below the kitchen. There's space enough for everything we need, utilities and so on. It's something we brought ourselves. And a really annoying thing is that when you have to close the top one, it needs an extra push. When you are standing still, no problems, you just close it. But when you're driving, the top one needs an extra push. And as you can see, there's a lot of space in it. And here, the last one, there's also space in here. Of course, something like that below is always difficult to get into. It would have been nice with a drawer or something like that. Maybe it was because of the pipes or whatever. Then up here, you have the control panel, where you can see how much battery is left on the house battery. Clients in the back are using for electricity. Then the car battery, I'm not sure why we want to see the car battery, because I don't think anything is really using the car battery as soon as the ignition is out. Then we have water. You can see we have 3/4 left. And then this one, we was told, should blink or do something when the gray water is full. And that's a nice thing that at least we're used to from a caravan, that the water is just going out of the caravan. In a motorhome, you have gray water where the water is staying in a bucket underneath, and then you're emptying that when it's full. Another really, really nice thing is this Truma CP Plus, where you can set the heat. So I could set that the heat should now be 20 and then the gas is starting to turn it on. Or I could say that the water should be eco, cold or boost. And it also has a ventilator, which could actually blow around air inside the motorhome. And that means that sometimes you maybe have cold in the bottom and hot in the ceiling if you make it ventilate. Somebody is saying that it would help at least cool it a little bit down inside the caravan as well. But it doesn't take cold air from outside. It could have been nice if it took cold air from below the car and blowed around in the motorhome. And then it has this timer, which we have been used a lot. So like you can see here, at 2 o'clock in the night until 9 o'clock in the morning, we want it to be 20 degrees and water we don't care about, it's off, and just slowly breeze around the caravan on. And that means that at 2 o'clock, it's gonna start trying to make the caravan 20 degrees, of course, depending how cold or hot it is outside. If it's hot outside, it can't do anything. Then, yeah, this is the charger I told you about the anchor. It's working really, really well. It's totally recommendable, this one. For USB chargers. And here is the only 230 voltage plug in the whole motorhome. You could of course just have an extension or something like that. Then there's again a total annoying thing here. You turn on the light for the toilet. Why don't you do that inside the toilet? I don't know why. Here you turn on the two lights in the top of the car inside. Maybe we should leave them on for now. Up here, there's a small cabinet, this, with a little bit of space. We've filled up everything because we're living in it right now. And up here, we also have a cabinet on top of the refrigerator. Then we have the refrigerator, a really nice refrigerator. It's blue, a cool feature, but actually when it's dark, the blue is really bad. You can't see anything. It should be red or something like that, I think would have been much better. It's filled up right now. It's a 150 liter with ice in here. And the nice thing is, I believe it's a refrigerator, so it's really, really cooling everything down. Here you can control how hot it should be. Maybe ours is a little bit too hot right now. And because it's a little bit noisy, then when you're going to bed at night, you can click this one. I don't know if it's something you can hear on the video, but it really is. There's a huge difference between this and this. So we click this in the night because we don't open it. It doesn't have to use as much power. And down here, you can have all your drinks and so on, or vegetables and so on. It's still kept cold down here as well. I think this one is really, really nice. On the bottom, there's another drawer. Cabinet, but you can't put anything in here. It's, you can see the water pipes is going here. If we just take the other side down here, there is also a cabinet where we have the Truma combi form, as it is called. You can turn on and off the gas. And in the back, I just discovered today that there is actually this iNet, so we could have connected an app for the panel I showed you before with the heat, which is really nice. Let's go to the bathroom. And I had to turn on the light on the other side of the motorhome, which is really annoying. There's a small window, which has a mosquito net as well. And blacked out curtain, and you can open it so you can get out the smell, if there should be any smell in here. And then you have the toilet here. The toilet is really great. We're using these taps from Trefort, and no smell at all when you're emptying it. You're emptying it from the outside of the car and taking out the cassette, but it's really tall. I wish it was a little bit lower. Would have made it more comfortable sitting on. Here, there's a small cabinet, and here, there's a bigger one with a lot of space. So all the things you need in a toilet, there's space for it. It has these three buckets here, but when you look around in here, you see a lot of wood and a big mirror and so on. Up here, that's where the shower head is going. So you can take out the shower head from here and put up there. It just feels wrong to shower in here with all this wood, and it's really, really small, and everything in here would get wet and so on. So it is a shower, you can shower, but do you want to do it? I don't know. We did it a few times for the boys because they're not too big. So, and there's two drains, which have been told is really nice as well, because if you're not 100% the level, it's either going up there or there. So that's a good thing. We have used the toilet for everything. A lot of people think it's bad. It smells bad when you're emptying it. It does not when you use the right chemicals in the toilet. Then you have the bed here in the back where me and May has been sleeping. You can remove this one. Take it up, and then you can go into the things from here if you want. It's a little bit of a hassle. You have to remove the bed and so on. And the bed is, we've been sleeping comfortable, I think. Or at least I can say I have been sleeping comfortable. No problems at all. It's wide enough. We are sleeping this way, and it's perfect. It's enough space for two people. And you have cabinets up here, and all our things is up here. All our clothes and so on. It's enough. We have clothes with us. We brought clothes with us for 10 days, and there is enough space up here, so no problem at all. Then we have the windows at the back. Since this model has mounted a bike rack, we can't open there. You can open them just a little bit, but really not a lot. Another annoying thing when you look at them is that it's like paper, and it's going out all the time when you push it, and it just feels like something that's gonna break anytime soon. So if it was my auto camera permanently, I think I would remove them and put in some more permanent blocking, something with some magnets on. And as you can see, it has speakers in the back, but I do not believe it's connected to the radio. The rental company has just put in some cheap radio. And it has a skylight, which is really, really nice. It's easy to put up and down, and there's a mosquito net and so on. We have it open almost all the time when it's when we are standing still to get out on the hot air. And then in my back, that is where the kids are sleeping. I will try maybe to see if I can show while I'm taking it down. That was how you took it down. It's so easy. Let's try to look how much space they got up there. As you can see, I think I almost think their bed is actually bigger than ours. The way they like to sleep is they like to sleep sideways as well as we do. And then it has this safety net here, which we put up every time so they don't fall down. It's a really big bed. I don't know actually how many kilos is allowed to be off here, but May and the boys has been playing up there without anything falling down. And for the ladder, you attach it here. You find the ladder here next to the refrigerator. And one thing is that we are forgetting to mount it properly every time we're driving. That's something you have to remember. But as soon as the bed is down, you can see there's still space in here to sit in the chairs if you want to. And even these chairs can be used. So we can still sit four people in here with the bed down, and the kids can easily sleep upstairs. So no problem at all. Another thing I just saw was that there's a light there. I have no clue why they put it there. You can see there's these things, that's where the air is coming out. I don't know if there's anything in the back, but they're all down there giving you a perfect hot air. We have been in 10 degrees and there's been really nice and warm. And there is an extra down here. It's a little bit extra cabinet where we have put our shoes and so on. It's really nice to have it. And of course it has the step when you go out here, take it in and out. And as soon as you start driving, it goes in automatically. Well, I think it's a really nice motorhome. It's probably 10,000 euros cheaper than the one we're actually looking at. And I can't say right now if 10,000 euros is justified. I can say that you can see that this is some cheaper model. There's shortcuts been made here and there, but for a family of four, if the kids are not too big, I would really recommend it, especially for holidays. It's really nice, and you can all fit. You can fit all your clothes, you can fit everything in here. You don't need a really big one. That's why we like these smaller ones, because we drove places where it says trucks were not allowed, and if you have a bigger one over the 3.5 tons, I do not believe that you're allowed to drive where we drove. In the city you can just park almost everywhere. It's best to find parking spaces where you can go a little bit out on the grass or something like that. Then it's not too long, it's only 6 meters. Height wise it's like 3 meters and wide it's 2 meter and 5 I believe. It's so easy to drive in the city, small cities everywhere. And that's why we really like this small size. I think it's a great car. We loved to drive around in for 10 days. Now we look forward to see the model. We are considering, we're gonna see that tomorrow. I really think that's a bit better model for us, since we're gonna stay in it for a longer time, but we could stay in this one for a longer time as well. One thing we were missing, of course, was the solar. We are a power-hungry family. We have our computers, iPads, phones, everything needs power. But other than that, a great car. Something we would recommend to try. We definitely loved it. So that was all from me. Goodbye.